You know what? Sometimes you have to fire an employee or a customer. And even, guess what? A member.
What?
James, fire a member? Are you kidding me? Just who the heck do you think you are? Well, ladies and gentlemen, in today's gig giveaway, I am going to answer that question and share with you what I feel are three reasons that justify when you need to fire the customer. And I will also share with you the best way to do it. And I don't mean by doing your best Donald Trump impersonation, you're fired. Hi, it's James Cronk of Golf Industry Guru, and for this week's gig giveaway, I want to talk about the taboo subject of firing customers. And yes, if you are a private or a semi-private club, that includes firing members. Now, I know this is not an easy or simple or straightforward topic, and obviously we must follow the laws of our land when it comes to issues such as the legal rights of customers, or a perception of discrimination or the abuse of authority. But what I am talking about today is when we believe it is within our rights and mostly the best interests of our club or business that, you know, just like there are times we must fire an employee, we sometimes must fire a member. So let me give you what I think are three examples, and I'm also going to use some sports analogies to help me explain my thinking. You know, I'm from Canada, and in hockey, there is a rule that you can't trip another player with your stick. And when one player uses his stick to trip another player, well, that's called a penalty. And you break the tripping rule, and then you go sit in the sin bin for 2 minutes. Now, at the golf course I manage, we have a rule that you need to check in with the golf shop before teeing off. The members don't like this rule. But without enforcing this rule, we'd have bedlam at the first tee. We'd have no record of who was playing in case of an emergency. And mostly we'd have no opportunity to sell Mr. Jones one of the new Adidas shirts we just got in. So if Mr. Jones breaks this rule once or even twice, well, there are progressive consequences. But if Mr. Jones believes that our club's rules don't apply to him, and this could be a rule about the first tee or about paying his bill on time or about, you know, getting into fisticuffs with another member because they're sitting in his bar stool, well then, you know, just like the hockey player who uses his stick to hit another player over the head, at some point, they go from getting 2 minutes in the penalty box to getting kicked out of the game. So my rule number one for justified reason to fire a customer is that they don't or won't follow the rules. Okay, so now, reason number two, which I gotta tell you is a little bit trickier. So getting back to sports, I'm going to use basketball as an example because it seems to me that basketball players literally try to get fired from their team sometimes. It's like they're just goading the general manager to trade them. You know, they talk bad about their coach or their teammates or their city. They just complain and complain and complain until eventually the coach and the teammates and even the city get so tired of their complaining that they say to themselves, man, this guy simply isn't worth it. Let's get him on the next bus to Oklahoma, Oklahoma, Oklahoma. So if you have a customer or a member that is never happy, no matter what you do, that sits on the bar stool of life and believes it's their job to tell everyone around them how bad it is at your club, and actually their club, while at the same time getting all the privileges and services that you try to deliver each and every day, well, then you need to find a way to help them go. Constant, uneducated negativity has no place in our employee culture, and it certainly has no place in our customer culture. It's a cancerous lump that needs to get surgically cut out, and you need to find a scalpel or a tool to get that done. Which brings me to my final reason for firing a customer, and that is protecting our staff. You know, well, you do know, because we're in the service business, and you know how difficult it is. We all show up every day. Our cooks, our cleaners, our servers, our maintenance staff, our golf shop staff, our accountants. We all show up each day trying to do our best and to deliver a great experience for each and every one of our customers and members. And we know it's not easy to satisfy hundreds of bosses each and every day. But you know, unfortunately, a club is like a ballpark in a baseball game, right? And every ballpark has at least one idiot yelling at the pitcher, telling him he's a bum. And every club has or will have a member that crosses the line and disrespects an employee in some way, shape, or form. It might be verbal abuse, it might be sexual innuendo, it might be a more subtle form of harassment. But if you're in this business long enough, you will be forced to deal with this issue. And there is nothing more important in creating a positive working environment than ensuring your staff have the confidence that you will protect them and that you will stand with them when issues like this arise. So when a member or a customer crosses that line, we need to tackle it head on. And when needed, we got to use the jaws of life to save the integrity of our staff and our club. So here's my final comment, and luckily for you, my final sports analogy, on some best practices for when it comes to firing anyone, whether that's an employee or a customer or a member or even a supplier. You know, first, everyone needs to know what game we're playing and why, and where the goalposts are. Second, everyone needs to start the game knowing what the rules are and what are the penalties for breaking a rule. Third, everyone needs to know who enforces the rules and how. And finally, and you know, probably for the same reason that they introduced video review to reduce diving in soccer games, is that when firing a customer, or anyone actually, it should never be a complete surprise. So that's it. One guy's opinion on when it makes sense to fire a customer. Thanks for watching this week's gig giveaway. And if you want to get access to tons of training materials for all of your staff, including employee, board, and directors, and even member evaluations, come join us on the inside at Golf Industry Guru. Online and on-demand training for your entire team from many of the world's leading golf and hospitality gurus for literally just $3 a day. So thanks so much for joining us. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, as well as hit the notification bell so that you can be notified when we upload a new video here on our gig channel. Thanks for watching, and as we like to say, we'll see you on the inside.